This is Optimal Health Daily, episode 1261, Why I Run Slow and Naked, by Emma Scheib of simpleslowlovely.com. And I'm Dr. Neil, your host and narrator. Hey there, happy Saturday. I hope your weekend is off to a great start, and welcome back to Optimal Health Daily, or OHD, where I act as your narrator of popular health and fitness blogs and always provide my commentary at the end. Now, we have a bunch of shows covering a bunch of different topics. Just search for Optimal Living Daily in your podcast app to find them. Now, when you first heard the title of this post, you were probably really intrigued, right? Well, you're just going to have to listen on to see what Emma is talking about. So let's get right to it and start optimizing your life. Why I Run Slow and Naked by Emma Scheib of simpleslowlovely.com. I'm going to tell you a story about how I've come to love slow and naked running, and how I've learned to embrace and have gratitude for the season of running I'm in. I started running about 15 years ago. A late bloomer to the sport, I started out running in between lampposts up and down Tinakori Road in Wellington. That's in New Zealand. I fell in love almost immediately. Well, that love-hate, but mostly love kind of relationship. About a year later, I completed my first half marathon. A few years later, I completed a 100-kilometer trail race as part of a team. My training style has varied little over the last 15 years. Always pushing myself, usually religiously, following some sort of training program, and never without my watch or phone with a running app tracking me. Until I discovered slow, naked running. I've always been a slow runner, pace-wise. I'm a tortoise, not a hare. I prefer to run slower and longer. I'd rather be out running for a couple of slow hours than busting a gut to get a personal best at a 5K or win a race. I'm not a competitive person in the slightest. Seriously, you don't want me on your team for anything. I just couldn't care less. But I've always pushed myself to achieve my own personal goals. But when I refer to slow running, I'm not necessarily talking about pace. I mean slow in an expansive, general way. What I mean is I take time to make my running a ritual now. I'm more mindful when I lace up and head out the door. I'm very aware that this is part of my self-care routine, not just another tick box on my to-do list. I'm not running to get fit or lose weight. I'm running for the pure joy of it, because it fills my cup. So naturally, as my life has slowed down, so has my approach to running. I no longer care that much for training programs. I try and run 4 times a week, but I don't beat myself up if I don't get there for whatever reason. I'm kinder to my body now, recognizing when it needs a break and giving it one, rather than pigheadedly pushing through pain and discomfort. And the naked part? I knew you'd stick around for that. Okay, I'm not actually naked. What I mean is that I no longer need to run with a stopwatch or a running app. I don't even need my route mapped out anymore. I often just pull on the necessities, clothes and shoes, and go. I don't decide my route or how long I'll run for in advance. I just go. Running in the forest or on trails has brought me to this place of mindfulness and simplicity with my running. My most favorite runs have been where I've actually got lost on the trails in the mountain bike park. It feels spontaneous and adventurous, something that isn't featured much in the rest of my life. Not having an agenda, a course, or a goal for the run frees me up to just be there and run, to be fully present with myself. I often stop to watch birds or pick up rubbish now because I can. If I want a walking break, I just take one. If I'm running in town, I'll even stop and chat with a friend in the middle of the run, where previously I would have yelled, "Can't stop, aiming for a personal best." I would do this even when I wasn't aiming for a personal best. I just didn't want to have my groove interrupted. This is the season my running is in right now. It feels autumnal, hunkering down for the long, slow winter ahead, pacing myself so that I can preserve energy for when the season changes. And it will. It hasn't all been easy and as lovely as slow and naked running sounds. I've often felt very impatient and frustrated that I'm not doing more, that I'm not training for another ultra marathon, that I'm not improving, or that I don't have my pre-2-baby body back. But I'm learning to be patient and to enjoy my autumn season. This is part of what slow and naked running is to me. It's stripping away all the shoulds and all the expectations. I should be training for something. I should go out running even though it's pouring rain. I should be doing speed work. Ugh. I'm learning to run for the pure pleasure of it. Not to run for the gains, for the calories expended, for the fat loss, for the medals, for the, oh my goodness, you ran how far? Running will always be part of my life. I'll be running as long as my body allows. So I'm taking care of it, the way it takes care of me. Maybe I'll run another ultra marathon one day. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll get faster. Maybe I won't. The only thing I'm sure of is that I'll run, no matter in what season or capacity. I run to heal. I run to be closer to God. I run to meditate. I run to feel free. I run to take care of myself. You just listened to the post titled, Why I Run Slow and Naked by Emma Scheib of SimpleSlowLovely.com. Dr. Neil here for my commentary. I'll be honest, running is one of my least favorite activities. I'd rather put my body through a grueling, high-intensity power training routine rather than run. But occasionally, I'll muster up some willpower and go for a run. And even then, it's usually not a long one. Instead, I'll use the run as part of my warm-up routine. But when I actually do it, just like Emma mentioned, I find it meditative. Once I stop cursing myself for making myself run in the first place, I usually stop cursing myself around the 5-minute mark, I find my brain starts to get into this meditative zone. My mind starts to get very still. It starts to feel clearer. It's like all other sounds and thoughts disappear. I just hear my footsteps on the pavement. I usually do feel great after my warm-up runs, which makes me wonder why I dread doing it in the first place so much. In fact, by sharing this with you and talking out loud about it, I may have just convinced myself to run more often. Huh, go figure. All right, that'll do it for today. I hope you're having a great weekend if you're listening in real time, and I'll see you back here tomorrow for the Sunday show and where your optimal life awaits.